So we'll give a brief introduction about each of us, followed by that maybe opening remarks, and followed by that, I think so both of you come from EPC side, so maybe you can speak more related to the EPC and new technology advancement in EPC, and maybe Ritesh, you can throw some light on the advancements on tracker side actually, yeah? And then if any questions, probably we can take over, yeah? So just to introduce, my name is Amit Barve. I work with Enerparc Energy, and I have been in this industry for long now, as what Anand mentioned, right from 2005, when solar was basically an off-grid industry rather than an on-grid industry. Seen lots and ups and downs when the system prices were in the range of like 350 rupees per watt peak, and today what we have seen is going down to the level of even less than 30 rupees per watt peak. So a huge change, a huge momentum that we have seen after the start of the National Solar Mission. And had an opportunity to work in the manufacturing company, including the product side, including solar modules, wafers, cells, and now leading the business development activities in Enerparc for the EPC solutions. Starting from our right, I would request Ritesh to give us a short introduction, and then we can start forward.
Yeah, hi. I manage the business development at Scorpius Trackers. Scorpius Trackers is the leading tracker manufacturer. It's completely made in India, including the mechanicals, the electronics, the electricals. Everything is patented from India globally. We are on the cutting edge of technology across the globe. In fact, we can proudly say that our technology is absolutely the best across the globe at this given point in time. Thanks.
Ashish, can you briefly introduce yourself?
Hi, I am Ashish. I'm close to Oriano Clean Energy. Oriano is an EPC player, as Amit was already mentioning. We started around 2.5 years back in this form. Before that, we had done 50 megawatts of solar thermal in a joint venture with Lauren of U.S. And in this avatar of ours, we have done around 85 megawatts, of which 10 megawatt is rooftop and balance is ground-mounted. Apart from this 85, we have around 100 megawatts under development and various stages of development. And all these, there are basically four projects totaling 200 megawatt, which all the four projects are going to be completed in next 2 months, October, November, December. One of them is getting completed in October, one of them is in November, and two of them in December. So end December, we expect ourselves to be roughly around 150 megawatt of work behind us. We have done all kind of work. When I'll come probably on the technology side, then I'll also speak. Whenever I'm explaining the technology, I'll also be giving the kind of work that we have done in that technology.
Kartik, maybe you can introduce yourself.
Right. Hi, I'm Kartikeya Narain Sharma. I'm representing Sunsure Energy. We are again a young EPC company, just like Oriano, around the same year old. We started in 2014. And the primary focus has been commercial industrial rooftop, of which we've put close to 17 to 18 plants. And then on the ground mounted side itself, also we are developing close to 30 megawatts. So a combined work of close to 35 megawatts under us, and yeah, really looking forward to the discussion.
Then probably I would like to start with Ritesh. I think so today, last 2 years probably, you have seen the development in terms of tracker getting much more recognition than the earlier years, and the rate of growth probably, or CAGR if you see in the tracker industry, is phenomenal. Today India is accepted tracker with wholehearted, most of the developers are really working with the tracker solution. So can you maybe elaborate more on the technological advancement which has really led to this boom, and moving forward, what kind of products you would like to continue taking it ahead from the Scorpius side?
Right. Thanks, Amit. So as a background, I think there is a drive from the perspective that you need power continuously throughout the day and the night. I think solar has that certain capacity to provide power throughout the day, which currently isn't isn't being matched by the technology that we have. It's like saying 2G technology current. The current technology is basically just put the panels, put them, stick them on a structure, and just generate energy maybe a couple of hours a day. That's where it's peaking. The rest of the time, you're barely able to eke out a few units on each panel. Now, the advantages that from a technology perspective that we brought to the table, I mean, we were completely made in India, completely developed. We have an excellent center in Pune. And we have 20 people working on this continuously, is on how to optimize the energy of the sun. Because if you have the energy only given 2 hours of a day, that's very difficult for the DISCOMs, very difficult for the government to actually justify that power to the entire grid. Because if you are looking at a couple of hours of power, what do you do with the rest? Where's the rest of the power coming from? So you're not able to actually eliminate the current polluting fuels, fossil fuels, nuclear. To a certain extent, nuclear is, while some people claim renewable, it has hazardous waste, which is absolutely not in the renewable sort of category. So from our perspective, what we are looking to do, and something that we've done successfully with more than a quarter of a gigawatt, 250 megawatt installed and growing tremendously. This year, we expect to do at least a couple of gigawatt. The focus that we have is delivering the maximum performance per unit from per watt peak, you could say, from each panel. Now, there are multiple advantages to that. One, the advantage is that you could get power from early morning till late evening. As long as the sun shines, you're getting power. You're getting stable and peak power. Peak power as in power, let us say, assume that it, if you have a 1 kilowatt system. A 1 kilowatt system will generate, using a standard model, about 5 units. If here, you can generate almost 7 to 8 units. Now, the additional units that you get are from the early morning and the late evening. So, basically, single axis technology keeps the sun always perpendicular, or you could say perpendicular or parallel to the incline of the plane. So from that perspective, you're always getting the maximum input from the sun and the maximum output from the panel. So that is where the importance comes in, because that is something that you can actually run industrial. So we are talking early morning power will start, I mean, you'll hit peak power at around 8 o'clock, even in the winter, till 8 to 4. So you have like almost 8 hours of power where you can actually run commercial, industrial, as well as residential requirements. You don't need to augment it with some other power. So our development has been in such a way that a lot of people have said, trackers, oh, moving parts. But you have moving parts everywhere. And the amount of moving parts that you have in a tracker and the amount of cycles that you do across 25 years, some moving parts like a car would do that in like a day. So the amount of wear and tear is not that high. We have tested our products for almost 150 years. 150 years, your panels also won't last, but our bushings and bearings and our mechanicals will last that. And these are all patented. So we have taken out the risk. We have tested at international level. We have tested at CPP labs. This is a boundary layer wind tunnel. Sorry, you don't have the presentation. It would have been much more easier for you to understand. Where you actually determine the wind flow, pressure coefficients. You determine a lot of actual turbulence, which would impact the panels, which currently does not happen in the current scenario. So in the current scenario, just a crude example is you've gone from a 120 tons first time solar was installed. Right now, people are talking about 20 tons, but there's no validation. There was no validation at 120 tons. There's no validation at 20 tons. So how do you know that's the correct number? So no fixed tilt, no seasonal tilt has ever been tested as rigorously as we have tested our products. So there's a huge amount of validation. We've got our engineering bankability. So the entire process flow, the entire manufacturing, the support, everything is taken care of by an engineering bankability, and that's a requirement for the American market. So we have plants in Japan. In Japan, we have advantage from the perspective that even though it's cold, even though it's foggy, we're still able to generate far more than the existing fixed tilt technology. So your optimization of space, that is important. At the end of the day, the efficiency, because every watt that you pay for, how much efficient. Plus, you would also create local jobs. let us assume that you're talking about fixed tilt, you're talking the tonnage would be maybe about 20, an actual good plant would be about 30, 35 tons. With trackers, with the kind of analysis that we've done, we are close to about 50 to 55 tons. And based on that, you have a lot of local labor, local engineering jobs, things that are currently necessary in this environment. That is something that definitely is happening. Another thing that's happening, I mean, from the technology perspective, I think China has been given a lot of importance from the perspective that people are now just importing even their structures from China. So a lot of local jobs are getting missed out because of that. Those are things that actually we need to focus more on growing made in India, make in India. That is something that needs to be focused. And it's not only about delivering power. It's also delivering a holistic ecosystem around that, so that you create not only energy security, you also create prosperity and wealth across the country. So that was our major ethos driving us, and that is what we've done. We've gone to the DISCOMs. NTPC now has our standards. Our standards are world class. Our quality is world class, is the best in the world right now on tracking. We have zero maintenance on that part of it. We are looking at a lot of value from the perspective that we have enhanced standards for government. NTPC is now using our standards as their standards for tracking. So we're doing that similar. We're working with different Tangedco. We're working with Telangana DISCOMs. We're working with all of them to improve their understanding and to ensure that they're not looking at power. Like when you say 1 megawatt, you say it is 1.6 million units. But 1.6 million units was only coming 2 hours a day. But if that 1.6 units could be divided 8 hours a day or 24 hours a day, that's where you have a real solution. And the advantage that we bring to the table is with storage, you can actually deliver 10 to 12 hours of peak power, and you could take care of most of the requirements across the nation. So that is where the next step of solar is coming. That's where technology has to go. It's like everybody saying that we have a 2G or old Nokia, we're happy with that, that's okay, it's working for us. But that's because you've not discovered the next level, right? So that is where we're coming from.
Thanks, Ritesh. I think so. I have some more questions, but maybe I'll go to the other panelists first. But that's very interesting perspective of tracker in combination with the storage to improve the PLF. I think so. That's a wonderful thing. Probably we all should be looking forward in a combination to move. Coming to Ashish, I believe you have been onto the EPC on the ground mounted, and you're currently executing 1500 volt system. Yeah, probably that is something which is really catching up as far as optimization of an EPC cost is concerned. Could you share some of your experience on how is the local chain, supply chain has really geared up on 1500 volt? What are the advantages of 1500 vis-a-vis 1000 volt systems, which has been prevalent into the market?
It reduces, it adds more strengths and reduces the requirement of your combiner boxes, your cables, trenches, the entire manpower. So the entire project cost gets reduced by a significant angle from a EPC point of view. Moreover, the voltage at which we supply to the transformer, that also reduces. So overall, the losses reduces. So this is one of the predominant advantages of 1500 volt. Apart from which, we are executing two of our projects under this mechanism. Apart from this, there are some other aspects of technology that I had thought upon that I'll touch. With your permission, I'll just briefly take it forward. If we talk about, say, the various types of technology, the types of modules that we have, there are three basic types of modules that we have there: mono, poly, and central. So mono is like a single crystal which is like broken down, and then that forms the cell. Poly, several small crystals are fused together, and then you are being from a manufacturing background, probably you will be able to explain better. But the point that I want to try and highlight was that poly has become more prevalent in the today's market because it is able to give more output per meter square. So that is why it has become more prevalent. The prices have crashed faster. And there is a third technology which is called a thin film, where a cadmium tension surface is loaded on a PV's surface. So the one of the predominant the earlier this technology was around 20-25% of the global market, but has now reduced significantly and is roughly around 5-10% of global market, because the market has expanded very significantly and most of the expansion has come out of PV. The first solar which does thin film, we are doing a project with them, and the size is roughly around 50 megawatt, which is completed in this month. So the brief idea that I wanted to touch upon all three, that there are advantages and disadvantages of all these three technologies, and depending upon your system, most of the companies choose the technology that they wish to go in with. Apart from 300 and the type of these three technologies, the other two or three things that make or break that where the efficiencies are increasing, the other technologies are changing, because of which the EPC work is getting transformed and the solar landscape per se is changing. Is one of the things is increase in wattage out of each module. So earlier we used to have 315 volt modules, now we are getting 325, 330. So again, the advantage that comes out is you get more output out of a module, and hence your strings become larger, which again leads to all the kind of savings that we discussed under the 1500 volt system. That we get a similar kind of advantage because the wattage per module increases. This also becomes very important when we are focusing on the rooftop segment, because area is critical and you have to get the maximum out of the limited area. So you might have a high consumption in the ground floor, but if your roof is limited, so it is better, the higher the output, it's basically your common sense. Ritesh has already touched upon trackers, so I think he's better than he is. But basically, we are doing some work on trackers also. We have done some large projects with him. What tracker is, in a nutshell, what I would like to just touch upon the commercial aspect is like there are areas where the productivity increases are in the range of 15-18%, if I'm not wrong.
Mm.
So, with a slight increase in your capital cost at one time, you are able to increase the productivity over the lifetime of the project. So, it makes sense, and that is why trackers have picked up in a large way in India. Yeah. So, these were some of the things that I thought about.
Ashish, one specific point what I wanted to check with you, since you are the couple of first one actually who's been doing into the 1500, was it really a challenging sourcing the components for the 1500 volt as far as balance of system is concerned? And overall, if you see on the EPC cost wise, what's kind of a differential between doing a system on 1500 volt and doing a system on 1000 volt? In terms of cost comparable on 1000 and 1500?
In terms of sourcing, I don't think it was much of a challenge, because it was a challenge, but most of the manufacturers were already there with these kind of systems, be it Hensel, be it Trinitar, and be it the cables. So, whichever, most of these guys were, once the commercial adaptability of the product was there in the market, then only we launched something. Because we also don't, or our customers per se, don't want to test a technology. Until unless we know that the entire gamut of things that are required for the projects are available, you can probably say that we might have a lesser choice of vendors. Maybe there are two or three, and we might have a larger lead time in terms of sourcing project products. But the products per se were available. That was one aspect. The other thing that you said was in terms of commercial changes.
Capital cost, yeah.
I won't be able to give you exact numbers, but
percentage.
In terms of percentage, I think it would be slightly higher, maybe a 5-10% kind of a change in terms of costing. But overall, the project cost was reduced by 5-10% because of the overall savings, the cables and everything, general costs.
Wonderful. Thanks, Ashish. I would like to go to Kartik, actually. Kartik, you have also been into the EPC space. Predominantly, you did a lot of rooftop projects, actually. How do you see the technological advancement happening under the rooftop space? Today, we keep hearing majority of the business in India is moving towards the rooftop. The highest anticipated growth right now is in the rooftop business, actually. So, would you like to elaborate on some of the technological advancements which are happening on the execution side or component side or selection and engineering side? Yeah.
Yeah, so you're absolutely right about the fact that rooftop is actually the fastest growing market when it comes to rooftop, when it comes to solar PV, I mean. And in terms of technology advancements, I would say that while I think that the largest or the most impactful advancement so far has been what Ashish also talked about, the fact that we are getting better wattage modules now as compared to earlier. As such, increase in efficiency and all is only marginal or not worth talking about. I think the most standout advancement that's happening on the rooftop solar side is coming on the processes front, right? So there are a bunch of technologies. First of all, there are a lot of companies which have come, you know, as developers, right? For example, CleanTech is one. They were here yesterday, where they've actually come in with a lot of world-class processes, and they've come in and they are kind of educating the Indian EPC environment, which is actually on the rooftop front is not more than 5 years old actually anymore. So those processes are coming in. With those processes, even us as a company and a lot of other companies, I feel, are creating technological interventions which can enable those processes more smoothly, let's say, or more surely, right? And so I think that's where we're doing it. And I've got a bits and pieces of that in my presentation, which I would like to, go through. So if you have the time now, if you could please put on the presentation.